Well, the most interesting experiences, I think, in my life have come through illnesses. Hmm. As a kid in a public sanitarium, seeing other kids around me, not all of whom got well, and some of whom had to be carried out. I naturally developed a tremendous longing for life as it might be lived outside the sanitarium. I had plenty of hope and plenty of love. As for laughter, this is something that was not beyond my means. And at night, we showed some of the funniest films that we could rent. And I made the very interesting discovery that 10 minutes of good belly laughter would give me 2 hours of pain-free sleep.
क्लाउनिंग को जब मेरे को नहीं पता था कि क्लाउनिंग क्या होती है, जब सबसे पहले मैं फेसबुक पे सर्च कर रहा था कौन से एनजीओ है अहमदाबाद में, जब मैं सर्च कर रहा था तो मेरे को कंपैशनेट क्लाउन्स के बारे में पता चला। तो मैंने वहाँ के कोऑर्डिनेटर वर्षा थी उस समय, वर्षा डोलानी, उनको कॉल किया कि मेरे को क्लाउनिंग करना है। तो उन्होंने मेरे को बताया कि GCS में एवरी सैटरडे हम लोग क्लाउनिंग करते हैं, तो क्लाउनिंग के लिए आप आ जाइए।
देयर आर टू वर्ड्स, मेडिकल एंड क्लाउनिंग, एंड इट इज सो पैराडॉक्सिकल। सो समहाउ वी ऑल वर अट्रैक्टेड टुवर्ड्स द टर्म।
Well, the thing is, as a child, I wanted to be a politician, so I guess I was born to be an actor. I turned away from politics when I turned 20, kind of disillusioned, and became a writer. I wanted to write movies. I had done some acting. I was always interested. Actually, when people ask me if I could do anything else, I'd love to be an actor. I don't know if I have talent for it, but I enjoy it a lot. I've studied acting as part of my master's degree, which was in theater. And I did playwriting, but also did some acting. And I fell into clowning and just loved it. So it fits my personality. I'm a natural born clown.
Initially, the cancer is not that physically attacking as much as it is mentally affecting. Just to see that C word in that file, in that report is so scary. कि कभी तो हुआ नहीं हमारे फैमिली में कभी सुना नहीं अचानक से कैसे आ गया and then why this is happening with us and this question ना why me that is bad and it takes quite some time not just for the patient but for the family to get the pen you know get this will to accept the challenge and to fight it so living under the shadow of big scene is a scary experience in itself.
तो मैं जाके वर्षा से मिला तो उन्होंने कहा सैटरडे को आप ज्वाइन कर लो क्लाउनिंग एक बार आके देखो. तो उस समय कोई इंटेंशन नहीं था कुछ भी नहीं पता था क्या होने वाला है बस इतना पता था कि वो लोग हॉस्पिटल जाते हैं और बच्चों को हंसाते हैं.
बिफोर गोइंग देयर इट वाज लाइक कंप्लीटली यू नो वी वर क्लूलेस व्हाट विल बी डूइंग इनसाइड देन वी पेंटेड आवर फेसेस एंड वी एंटर्ड. नाउ मेकिंग दिस किड्स लाफ दैट्स अ डिफिकल्ट टास्क फॉर अस फॉर because none of us come from any kind of performance art or any kind of acting background.
When clowning came up, I heard about it, I thought, okay, I want to try that. So the biggest reason when you say, why are you doing it, is I fell in love with it. Partly from an ego standpoint, because I did it, and suddenly everybody at the clowning group, when we sat down to like decompress at the end, were like, I've never seen anything like that. And the other part of it is that it gave me a chance to work on something that I've been doing a lot as I've gotten older, is letting go of what other people think of me. As a clown, you're wearing a mask, and you're expected to be a little bit strange, a little different. And I've taken that to the limit, you know. Standing on your head in the middle of a hospital ward, waving your, you know, legs around is not something you see very often. So for me, that was very freeing. I loved it. It was really, really, it touched my heart. Clowning is an activity that so far, even with quite a lot of conscious thought, I haven't figured out what I'm doing, what it means to me, what it might mean to others. I think that it's a very strange activity. You're bringing smiles and laughter into a place that's very close to death. And there's something about that that's, it appeals to me. It appeals to my sense as a human that it's something I want to face, I want to deal with. It's not easy. It's a very, very strange activity.
Cancer is a multimodality treatment. So we have the surgery, we have chemotherapy, and then we have radiotherapy. we have experienced that people of the same stage of the disease being treated with the same treatment responds differently. So what are the factors which are affecting the treatment outcome for that patient? Clearly, there is something which medicine does not incorporate as of now, which we have not focused as of now. And those patients who are positive all through, they respond better. And it has not been just my experience. Those people who are working for 30 years now know that, you know, this person, this patient is educated, this person is taking things positively, he or she is going to respond better.
Say 15. At that time my mother was detected with cancer, and that is the most crucial time or most, you know, fun time of anybody's life. At that time I have gone through this pain, traumas, ups and downs of cancer. So I have seen cancer so close. So it is like, it's not like that only the patient is going through the trauma. It is the whole family. Okay, patient is going through the pain, the emotional, everything. But along with that, family is scared. I mean, because cancer means cancel. So you are not aware whether your this patient would be cancelled from the world, from your family, or they would be still surviving, or they are dying every day. So that is a horrible trauma, horrible depression whole family is going through.
जब हम क्लाउनिंग के टाइम मास्क पहनते हैं या मैं अपनी टोपी पहनता हूँ तो मैं अपनी आइडेंटिटी भूल जाता हूँ। पीछे वाली टोपी है। जैसे ही मैं इस टोपी को पहनता हूँ तो मेरे में एक अलग ही चेंज आ जाता है, यानी मैं लाइफ के सारे चीज़ें भूल के, मेरे को बस एक ही चीज़ का टारगेट रहता है, हर बच्चे को हंसाना है। वहाँ जितने भी बच्चे हैं, बच्चों के साथ साथ उनके पेरेंट्स है, केयर टेकर है, तो हम लोग सिर्फ एक ही चीज़ करते हैं क्लाउनिंग करते समय, सेल्फलेस लव स्प्रेड करते हैं।
The dynamic in clowning, and it's a very emotional activity. I find that when I enter the ward, if the first few children are very, very sick, I have a very hard time getting my energy up. But there was a time, and so it's dealing with the sickest of the sick children. Many of them make it very clear that they don't really want anybody there. And I try to do a few little stunts and things to see if they'll open up and want me to approach. I have a simple thing that I do normally, unless they're very much like go away, which is just go and hold their hand and, you know, pet them a little bit and just look at them, trying to find empathy.
Like, you know, it has been medically proven that stress can be the predisposing factor for many kind of cancers. Like, you know, CA breast is particularly seen in high-profile women. It's not a disease of lower socioeconomic class. Same way, many kind of brain tumors too. So, like, there are many researchers which back this theory up that, you know, stress can be the starting point of cancer. And if that is scientific, then de-stressing is also a scientific modality to treat cancer. And I think clowning gives you that.
See, basically, cancer is such a mainstream business. I'm using the word business. For the only reason there are most of the pharmaceutical companies are doing research on it. Most of the business houses are having funds allocated for cancer research or cancer charity or helping the patient. Okay, that is going on. And that is good. Nothing bad in it. But who's there spending time with them? I mean, you give money and then you somehow forget your responsibility after that. I mean, paise de ke chhoot jana aaj ke zamane mein sabse easiest baat hai. Koi bhi jagah pe. Aap wahan jaate ho, unke saath time spend karte ho. और टाइम स्पेंड करने का भी तरीका है ना कि आप वहाँ जाके यू डोंट नीड टू सिंपथाइज देम कि बेटा ठीक हो जाएगा. हाँ जी आपका बेटा ठीक हो जाएगा तो वो पता है. लेकिन व्हेन एट माय टाइम माय रिलेटिव्स यूज्ड टू कम एंड टेल मी बेटे सब ठीक हो जाएगा बेटा ये मेरे मुंह से गालियाँ निकलती थी. क्या है मतलब ब्लडी आई नो आई एम सिटिंग इन द हॉस्पिटल व्हाई यू नीड टू टेल मी ऑल द टाइम दैट शी विल बी फाइन. ऑफ कोर्स शी वुड बी फाइन. दैट वाज माय बिलीफ. आई डोंट नीड दैट. सो एज दिस दीज पीपल. And secondly, raising money is not a huge issue. We are into project finance. We raise huge money. A hospital banana is not a difficult task. Believe me, I can give you money tomorrow. Raise money tomorrow. And it would be like easiest thing. So spending time with them, make them happy and make them, you know, world this surviving atmosphere in that boring cancer ward. So this is the reason I keep doing it.
एटमोसफेयर ऐसा होता है कि 7 दिन तक पेरेंट्स के लिए बच्चों को इस तरह से देख पाना भी बड़ा मुश्किल काम होता है. तो उस सिचुएशन में हम अपनी लाइफ को एक अलग रोल अदा करते हैं. मैं अपनी लाइफ जैसे वहाँ उन लोगों के लिए कभी कुत्ता बन जाता हूँ, कभी यानी कभी उनके लिए ऐसे ऐसे रोल करता हूँ, मिमिक्री करता हूँ. कभी मेरा एक फेवरेट टोन है यानी वो चेहरे पे जो खुशी आती है उन बच्चों के, यानी कुछ भी नहीं करता हूँ, सिर्फ उनके साथ टाइम स्पेंड करता हूँ और खुद के रोल को चेंज कर देता हूँ अपनी लाइफ को. हर बच्चे की अलग नीड होती है. कोई चाहता है कि मैं उनको जोकर बन के हंसाऊँ, कोई चाहता हूँ मैं उनसे दूर रह के बात करूँ या दूर रह के कुछ भी डांस करूँ. तो उन्हें देखना पसंद होता है, उन्हें हंसना पसंद होता है. तो मेरा कैरेक्टर हर जगह अलग होता है, यानी किस बच्चे को जो पसंद है हर बच्चे को उसके हिसाब से मैं ढल जाता हूँ. किसी को बलून खेलना पसंद है तो उनके साथ बलून खेलता है. कोई बच्चा सोया हुआ है तो मैं उनके साथ सिर्फ कुछ भी नहीं करता, उनके साथ उसके सर पे हाथ रख के 5 मिनट तक वहाँ बैठा रहता हूँ.
For me, clowning is very personal. I'm a little bit antisocial when I go to clown. It's me and the kids, and I try to make very strong one-on-one connections with each child as I'm playing with them. There's times when I actually leave the ward in the middle of clowning to have a little bit of a cry when it's overwhelming, or I just go out and take a breath and try to relax. And so it just depends. It depends on who you've dealt with and how it's happened.
मैं
कभी किसी क्लाउनिंग करते समय किसी को किसी का नाम नहीं पूछता, न उनसे उनके रोग के बारे में पूछता हूँ, यानी किस तरह का आपको कैंसर है या क्या है, क्योंकि अदरवाइज वो मेरे को इम्पैक्ट करेगा, मेरी लाइफ पे इम्पैक्ट करेगा। मैं उनके बारे में सोचूंगा उनको क्या हुआ है, किस तरह से जी पाएंगे या नहीं पाएंगे। मैं वहाँ से क्लाउनिंग करने के बाद घर आता हूँ तो मैं याद नहीं रखता किस बच्चे को क्या हुआ है, या न मेरे को पता होता है कि क्या उस बच्चे को हुआ है। तो मैं क्लाउनिंग इसी तरह से करता हूँ कि वो मेरी लाइफ के ऊपर इम्पैक्ट ना करे।
I have a simple thing that I do normally, unless they're very much like go away, which is just go and hold their hand and you know pet them a little bit and just look at them, trying to find empathy, trying to say that I can't be where you are, but I feel for you. But there was a time, there was a very, very sick little boy, and he was open for me to come and sit with him, and I was like kind of smiling a little bit at him, but I didn't expect him to smile. But his parents were very open. They were really liked me being there. So every time, I think during the clowning, I came back maybe 4 or 5 times and I sat there and held his hand. And then one time I got the idea to come behind the father and start tickling him. And I did this. This is the first time I did it. And the little boy who was, I mean, he was skin and bones. He was so sick. He smiled. And, this is just a small little moment. But to see somebody in so much pain, and to feel like I found that one thing that can make them smile.
Week I went, there was again one girl, grown up enough, was waiting actually for us to arrive to just share the news that Didi, we are done with our cancer thing, now we are going out in the world. Wow, this is a beautiful experience. And I am doing it because I want to believe. Though your medical science don't, it's me and it's my belief.
Hello. Good morning. Bolo Devendra.
क्लाउनिंग का इम्पैक्ट मेरी लाइफ पे बहुत ज़्यादा रहा है। जब मैं जैसे मैंने क्लाउनिंग चालू की थी, उसके थोड़े टाइम बाद ही मेरा तलाक हो गया था। तो यानी उस सिचुएशन में इंसान यानी एकदम नेगेटिव हो जाता है, और मैं काफ़ी अटम्प से फेल भी हो रहा था। यानी मैंने सीए फाइनल के 4-5 अटम्प दिए थे, फेल हो रहा था। लेकिन जैसे ही जब मैं क्लाउनिंग करता था, मैं सारी चीज़ों को भूल जाता था, मेरी नर्वसनेस ख़त्म हो जाती थी। क्लाउनिंग करने के बाद मेरे में एक पॉजिटिव एटीट्यूड आ जाता था, मैं किसी भी इंसान के साथ बात कर सकता था। जब क्लाउनिंग करने से पहले मैं एकदम साई बन जाता था, यानी मुझे किसी से बात करते हुए तो हिचकिचाता था कि इससे बात करूँ या नहीं करूँ, वो क्या सोचेगा।
Cancer, he had acute lymphoblastic leukemia. I was 12 years old, my sister was 11 years old. And then they took treatment, they took treatment in Mumbai. So my parents were in Mumbai for 11 months. And my father was on ventilator, like he was semi-conscious. And for that brief moment, he called me close and he hugged me. I was lying there and he hugged my sister. And then he wrote something on a paper and gave it to my uncle, my maternal uncle, saying that take care of them. And I don't know, I mean, a person who is this sick can get this much energy to talk to his family because he wanted to talk to his family. But there was this counselor, and my sister was too young and she was very attached to my father. So for a very long time, it had been 2 hours since my dad was declared dead, and she had not shed a tear. Nothing. I mean, for this smaller girl to hold back her emotions, you know, it was not a good thing. Everybody was trying everything, and then there was this counselor, and she hugged her and she asked ki papa bahut yaad aayenge na, papa bahut acche the. And then she, you know, there was all this, she started crying and all. And I think of all the people in the hospital, I remember is going to be that counselor, because you know, there was this human touch. I don't think I will, I mean, the touch of chemotherapy, who injected the needle, who put the port, who did this planning, who put the scalpel, I don't think I'll remember that person, or any patient will remember the person, but they will remember that person who touched their life.
किसी को भी उल्लू मत बनाना।
My favorite fruit is apple.
चलो।
My banana.
ये हम लोग लिफ्ट से आ रहे थे, मैं खाना लेके इसके लिए ले आ रहा था, तो एक औरत मिली, तो वो भी ऊपर सातवें फ्लोर पे जा रही थी, तो वो इससे पूछी इसके हाथ में वो लगा हुआ था
वीगो,
तो हाँ उसी को देख के उसको लगा कि यही पेशेंट होगा, तो उसने पूछा इस औरत ने इससे कि बाबू क्या हुआ है, तो ये डायरेक्ट बोला, पहली बार इसके मुंह से मैंने सुना था कि मुझे ब्लड कैंसर हुआ है, एकदम हंस के बोला मुझे आंटी ब्लड कैंसर हुआ है, वो हंस रहा था। और मैं मतलब यहाँ की दीदी से भी बताया, हमको पहली बार इसके मुंह से मैंने ये सुना था कि मुझे ब्लड कैंसर, इसको पता था।
मैं बालस माता से सता हूँ।